Good morning, students. Today we will start with chapter number 15, the rest of the sums, that is from question number 7. Okay, now your question number 7 says, to know the opinion of the students about the subject statistics, a survey of 200 students was conducted. The data is recorded in the following table. Now this is the data, okay, to know the opinion of how many students, that are 200 students, okay. A survey is conducted and this is the data from the survey. Opinion, that is like and dislike, and number of students, those who like the subject statistics are 135, and the number of students, those who dislike the subject statistics are 65. Now you have to find the probability that the student chosen at random. First question is like statistics and second question is does not like statistics. Okay, so you have to choose it. Your solution will go like, total number of students whose opinion is obtained, they are 200 students. Okay, now question number 1 is number of students who like statistics, that are 135 students. Now probability of students who like statistics will be 135, that is number of possible outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes are 200, so that will be 27/40. Now second question is number of students who do not like statistics. So number of students who do not like statistics is 65. So probability of students who dislike statistics, who do not like statistics, is 65/200. So that will give you 13/40. Now question number 8 says, refer to question number 2, exercise 14.2. What is the empirical probability that an engineer leaves? Okay, first is less than 7 km from her work or place of work. Second is more than or equal to 7 km from her place of work. And third is within 0.5 km from her place of work. So this question is on page number 245 of your textbook. Take it out. So this is your question. The distance in kilometers of 40 engineers from their residence to their place of work were found as follows. Now this is the data. This is the distance of engineer. Now you have to check. Okay, now what you have to check? Probability of an engineer living within 7 km. This is your first question. You have to find probability of an engineer living within 7 km. You have to find it out. Okay, now see, probability of an engineer living within 7 km is, this is less than 7, so you have to count this. So 1 2, then which is equals to 7, you don't have to count that. Okay, so we are counting just less than 7. So this is 1 2, then 3, then 4 5 6 7 8 9. Okay, total 9 are there. So your probability of an engineer living within 7 km from the place of work will be 9/40. So your solution will go like, total number of engineers are 40 and question number 1 is probability of an engineer living within 7 km. So from place of work. So there are total 9 engineers and total number of engineers are 40. So your answer will be 9/40. Okay, this will be your answer. Now second question is probability of an engineer living at a distance more than or equal to 7 km. Okay, living at a distance more than or equal to 7 km. See, we had found for less than 7 km. Now more than or equal to 7 will be found from, see, we are getting less than 7, that is 9. So more than or equal to will be 40 minus 9, that is 31. So your number of possible outcomes is 31 upon total number of outcomes is 40. So 31/40 will be your answer. Now next, last is probability of an engineer who is living within 0.5 km from place of work. See, there are 0 engineers who is living within 0.5 km. We had not given any kind of distance as 0.5 in that data. So that is 0/40, and 0 upon anything is 0. So your probability is 0 over here. Now question number 9 and question number 10 are activity that we are not going to do. Directly come on question number 11. That is, 11 bags of wheat flour, each marked 5 kg, actually contain the following weights of flours in kgs. These are the flours, weight of flours, that is there, that is 4.97, 5.05, 5.08, 5.03 up to, these are the weights, okay, of total 11 bags. 11 bags you are having. Now you have to find the probability that any of this bag chosen at random, any bag chosen at random contains what? Contains more than 5 kg of flour. You have to count the bags which is having more than 5 kg of flour. Now you cannot count the bag which is exactly 5, okay, because it is clearly mentioned over here that is more than 5 kg. We have to count for more than 5 kg, not exactly 5. So this is 5.05 more than 5, 5.08 more than 5, 5.03 more than 5, 5.06 more than 5, 5.08 more than 5, 5.04 it is more than 5, and 5.07 is more than 5. we are not counting exactly 5, okay? We are only counting more than 5. So how many bags are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So your 7 bags are there and total number of bags is 11. So your answer will go like, total number of bags is 11 and number of bags having more than 5 kg of wheat flour is 7. So your probability of bag will be number of possible outcomes upon total number of outcomes, that will be 7 by 11 your probability will be. Then question number 12. In question number 5, exercise 14.2, you were asked to prepare a frequency distribution table regarding the concentration of sulfur dioxide in the air present in parts per million of a certain city for the 30 days. Using this table, find the probability of the concentration of sulfur dioxide in the interval 0.12 to 0.16 on any of these days. See, now you have to find first go to that table. That table is on page number 245 of your textbook. Yes, this is your question. A survey was conducted to find out the concentration of sulfur dioxide in air parts per million of a certain city. The data obtained for 30 days is as follows. Now this is your data for 30 days. Now what you want to find? You want to find the number of days on which the concentration of sulfur dioxide is in the interval between 0.12 to 0.16. Now count all the values between 0.12 to 0.16. Okay, there are only two values between 0.12 to 0.16. Count it out. Your solution will go like, total number of days is 30. Now the total number of days on which the sulfur dioxide concentration is in the interval between 0.12 to 0.16, it is 2. Now probability of a day will be 2 by 30 because we are having sulfur dioxide concentration on the interval, that is 0.12 to 0.16, is for 2 days only. So 2 divided by total number of days, that is 30. So we will have 1 by 15 as our final answer. Okay, then move for question number 13. Question number 13 is, in question number 1 of exercise 14.2, you were asked to prepare a frequency distribution table regarding the blood groups of 30 students of a class. Okay, you have to prepare a frequency distribution regarding the blood groups of 30 students of a class. Now use this table to determine the probability that a student of this class selected at random has blood group AB. Now you have to find the probability that a student which is selecting at random, okay, we are picking up just one student at random, and that student is having probability of that his blood group will be AB. Okay, now you have to find this thing. First of all, move to that question. That is question number 1, exercise 14.2. See, this is your question. The blood groups of 30 students of class are recorded as follows. That is, this is the, okay, blood group of students. Now, represent this data in the, you don't have to see this. What you have to find is, you have to find probability of a student whose blood group is AB. So, count out the students who are having blood group AB. So, see, first, A is there, B is there, O, then this is AB. Okay, one we had found, then O, A, O, B, A, O, B, A, O, O, this is not, then second is here, that is AB, and third is here, then okay, only three are there. Okay, so total number of students are 30, and we are having only three students who are having blood group as AB. So your solution will go like, see, total number of students are 30, and probability of student whose blood group is AB, there are only 3. Okay, so your answer will be number of possible outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So that will be 3 by 30, means you will get 1 by 10. Okay, this is 3 ones are and 3 tens are. So this is 1 by 10. So this is your solution. Your chapter probability is over here.